Hello friends, a warm welcome to Family Recipe Ghar. Today let's learn how to make Salla Up Curry. Salla means raw jackfruit slices that had been brined in salt, as you all know, the details of which is provided in the description box below. Let's quickly check out the ingredients for that. Here I have salla, about 3 fists from my hands. Since it is brined, it will be very salty, so we need to add lots of water and soak it for about half an hour in the water to remove the salt concentration so that our Salla Up Curry will be less of salt. Here I have coconut oil for tadka, mustard, some curry leaves. This is tamarind, small size, actually half of a lemon size also. That's all, because I have taken just about 7 red chilies. These are badagi chilies, they give only color and not spicy. And this is hing paste, which is dissolved in about 2 teaspoons of water. After half an hour, we need to change this water again and replace it with fresh water, because the water in which it was standing will be very salty. So again, fresh batch of water needs to be added so that the salt concentration comes down. Do the Salla Up Curry. Only then we can use it for Salla Up Curry. Otherwise it will be very salty. This chili needs to be ground into a fine paste along with hing water and tamarind extract. I have squeezed the tamarind and I have taken the pulp. Now check this. This is very dry. You need to use sun-dried chilies so that the paste will be smooth, or you can even microwave it on 600 for just about 30 seconds and it will be dry. So let's make a paste out of this. I'm adding the hing paste now, not much, very little, and the tamarind pulp, maybe 1 spoon, that will do. After grinding the red chilies, hing and tamarind extract, you'll get a smooth paste like this. Look at the bright color. After about half an hour, I'm going to change this water again and replace it with fresh water. The water is replaced and we need to stand it for another 20 minutes to lessen the concentration of salt. I shredded the raw jackfruit slices or salla and dunk them in water, because the more area of the salla exposed to the water, the salt concentration comes down. Let's drain this water and mix it with the masala paste. The ground paste is now mixed with the salla. I have used up all the masala here. Now let us make Salla Up Curry out of it. Into my kadai, I have added about 2 tablespoons of oil and some mustard seeds. Swirl it like this so that your kadai gets nicely coated with oil. I have taken coconut oil. While making Salla Up Curry, you can use oil that has remained from your frying pan, like all the pakodas or any fryams or fritters that you use. The remaining oil from that can be used in making Salla Up Curry. The mustard seeds are crackled, in goes the curry leaves, and now let's add this. Give it a good mix. This salla is soft variety and it gets done faster, but if you are using a little harder variety of salla, then you may need to sprinkle some water so that the salt gets cooked first, and then you need to stir fry to make it like a roasted Salla Up Curry. This variety salla gets cooked with the masala paste and the tamarind extract and the hing water that we have used in grinding the paste. So I'm not going to add more water to this. Keep stirring it every 2-3 minutes so that it doesn't get stuck to the bottom of the non-stick. Here I am using non-stick for the same reason, because if you use any other kadai, it will get stuck at the bottom. So non-stick kadai is the best to make salla up curry because it will get nicely roasted and you will get strands separated out unstuck. That's the beauty of. After about 10 minutes, you can see that the salla is nicely cooked and soft. After about 15 minutes on low flame and stirring intermittently, you can see that salla curry is all done and ready and it's crisp. You can see crisp from outside yet soft from inside and well cooked. Now let's put off the flame. I'm getting the lovely aroma of hing and chilies, you know, all being roasted with the salla and it's superb. Our salla curry is all done and ready to be served. It's so yummy looking and tempting, isn't it? Have a closer look. So crispy from outside and soft from inside. Too good. It goes very well with our porridge or curd rice. It's a beautiful combination. You will love it for sure. Salla is easily available nowadays at our green grocers. They usually keep it in PET bottles. So you can go and get a small quantity and try this recipe. If you guys love this recipe, please hit the thumbs up button and share it with your near and dear ones. Please don't forget to subscribe to Family Recipe Ghar channel for more such interesting recipes. So, happy cooking. Take care. Bye-bye.